And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Vladimir Spiders. Today we're going to be going back and playing our two aggressive Vladimir decks. I really liked both of them whenever we played them like 2 and 3 days ago respectively. And so that's going to be two of our decks today, playing some more Vladimir aggro. We got Vladimir Spiders to start it off, and then later on we're going to have Vladimir Rally, as you can see. And then the other two decks we're going to have are our Karma decks. We're going to have the Spooky Karma that we only played the one time, but is a pretty fun deck to play. But, you know, it's another Shadow Isles, you know, deck, but bigger, you know, with Hecarim and stuff like that. And, oh, actually, the deck doesn't have Hecarim, does it? But Harrowing, there you go, and stuff like that. And then I'm trying out a brand new brew here with Teemo Wayfinder. That's going to be our last deck of the day where... I'm going to be trying, you know, like we tried Teemo aggro the other day, Puff Cap aggro, and it didn't go so well. Our deck was a little too slow. So I'm going to be trying a Teemo midrange deck, and I'm going to be trying to pair Teemo with Kinku Wayfinder, where Kinku Wayfinder, you know, the Allegiance can put 2 1-drops into play, and hopefully we go put 2 Teemos into play. It's tough, though, because you need a, you know, for Allegiance, you need a lot of Ionia stuff. We'll see how it goes. The deck could... you know, it's possible it doesn't work too well, but maybe it's awesome. So we'll try that later on. All right, but first, Vladimir Spiders. You know, we're taking our spider archetype with Elise and with a bunch of fearsome spiders like Frenzied Skitterer and Arachnid Horror, and pairing it with Noxus for the aggressive elements of Noxus. Noxus gives us some good one drops. We got Leech in Rearguard and Precious Pets, you know, another good spider. And then we got Crimson Disciple. Whenever this survives damage, we do 2 damage to our opponent. You know, House Spider helps us go wide. We got Crowd Favorite to make a big overwhelm creature. And then, of course, we have the Vladimirs to help finish games out with the attack trigger doing damage to the enemy Nexus. I also loved Transfusion in this deck before. I think Transfusion is just an awesome spell. So having access to both Transfusion and Mark of the Isles gives us really good cheap pump spells. And I like both of those. All right, that's our deck. So here we go. Let's go play 10 matches in ranked. We're playing just this row right here today. Spooky Karma, Teemo Wayfinder, Vladimir Rally, and Vladimir Spiders. All right, here we go. So against Zed Hecarim, I'll just get rid of the Glimpse Beyonds. Get some more spiders. I really like how the turns are here. It is very fair. It doesn't, you know, it's not a big deal whether you're on the play, on the draw kind of thing. Cause like that, it's not really play draw. Like it's each player gets the, you know, the turns, each player is playing stuff. This game is just awesome. Yeah, Frenzied Skitterer, so good. Definitely one of our best cards. So they granted an ally in hand Ephemeral and reduced the cost by 1. That thing's a 2-1. It can't block our 2-1 because our 2-1 is fearsome. So I'm just going to let that damage happen.
I pull the strings.
So you're saying finding, you're making shards out of the expeditions is slow. All right, so kill Elise. Oh, okay. You meant making shards for anything but expeditions. Gotcha. Yeah. I mean, it depends on like where you are in your regions. You know, like that's what it depends. Because to make shards when you're playing your regular XP, you know, you got to be winning. You know, you got to be leveling up your region. So if you're already leveled up a good amount of regions and you know you're on, you know, level 10, 11, 12, stuff like that, it does take a while to level up. Yeah, rank up Monday. That's like we had the rank up Sunday stream.
Where's my axe?
That, you know, we played our tier one decks. Today we're still playing good decks, you know, it's not like we're not playing good decks, but we're playing some other decks I enjoy. Ooh. We're gonna get a good amount of damage in. They're not gonna be able to block any of the fearsome creatures, so they have just a singular 2/3 to block. Oh, up here in the corner. I didn't delete that. I see what you're saying. So, taking 15, going down to 2. Alright, we just gotta finish out 2 points of damage. Doesn't seem too difficult. Doesn't seem too difficult to get 2 points of damage in.
The people are my strength.
It's the problem with all this can't block stuff, you know, it's just, you know, it can't block. Wait, why don't you let it hit first and do 3 damage and then you sacrifice it? I could just be at 13.
Reporting in.
Alright, Blade. Have fun. You're running 1 9-drop destroy all creatures in the spider deck for the tougher matchups. Okay, I like that. Yeah. Especially when you're starting out, get a ruination in there. People don't expect it, and yeah, you can just get a, you know, ruination and, you know, get a huge blowout and then play a bunch of spiders afterwards. Hey, what's up, JWR? Yeah, Legends of Runeterra is so sweet. Yeah, so I'm streaming it every day, you know, this time, and hope to see you around more and on the YouTube channel and everything. But glad to have you here. All right, 1-0. So basically, those can't block creatures have, you know, like they're basically impossible to deal with over a super long game, but they are just really, really slow. Hey, JWR, getting that Twitch Prime sub back on here. Thank you so much for resubbing. Oh, I need to reset the sub goal. That was yesterday's. So today we are at 1 out of 5. All right, we got 1, 2, 3, 5. That seems like a good curve. Okay, you're running 2 of the 6/6 for 10 that costs 1 less for each creature that has died this game. I think that may be a 5/5.
You will suffer long.
Yeah, it is a little bit of a pain to collect cards in the game. Yeah, I agree. For like, yeah, for somebody like me trying to make a whole bunch of different decks, yeah, that it is kind of a pain because it is limited to how many wild cards you can buy and everything. But no, I'm happy with how it's coming along. And
do not fear the shrouded path.
There's nothing to fear.
Your new favorite's Anivia control? Nice, yeah. I don't have Anivias. I wish I did. Oh, right. All right, Elise.
My true
do your thing.
Beauty is beneath the skin.
Yeah, the only way to get gold is to spend money. Like that's like the currency in the game. All right, so this is obviously going here. And this is going here. So that spider has fearsome. I'm going to do this one instead. Yeah, the money value is, it's basically, you know, like 100 gold is like a dollar, basically. If, as long as you buy like a bigger bundle of gold. Like how the Elise has like all those little spiders running on it. All right, so we have to just kill our Elise right now, draw two, so that their Zed doesn't lose Ephemeral. Have just the four cards in hand, which I also have four cards in hand, so you know, like we're keeping up with them there. I guess the reason to use my 2/1 fearsome instead of the 2/2 is because of Vladimir.
The Yordle here is with me.
Return to us.
It's me taking six. No, you're right. Vladimir doesn't have great synergy with the one toughness units. That is true. So this specific game isn't really a great Vlad game. But I have been just very happy with Vlad just in general besides that in this game. Or, like, in this deck. Alright, so I want... You. Then you. Harvey, stop. Yeah, Vladimir can help push through those last points of damage and, you know, just a big creature that's difficult to, or a big unit that's difficult to get rid of. But no, this hasn't been a great Vladimir game. We don't always have, like, this many, like, little spiders like this with one toughness. It's just kind of how this game's played out. So this is... alright, so 5, 7, 15. So this is 15 damage. So they would go down to 5.
Let me show you what I can do.
Thanks, Red. Yeah, glad you like the new camera spot. Just put it where basically all the other streamers have it. You know, like, they have, like, this blocked off area here that's just designed for the camera. Looks like. Those darned elusive units. Get you every time. I could have chump blocked the other two power creature the turn before, but it wouldn't have mattered. Like, they were doing 15 damage there. Okay. So, like, I like this hand, but we are attacking turn one. Oh no, I'm gonna just keep it. I like this hand. I could see getting rid of, like, the crowd favorite maybe, but I don't know. Maybe we'll just draw one drop. Nope. We got the Noxus part of our deck.
Where's my axe?
Hey, Bice Cream, it's going great. Yeah, Runeterra is a lot of fun.
You won't get past me.
Yeah, Vladimir, for each other attacking ally, you do one damage to it and one damage to the opponent. So every one toughness creature you have.
Let's get a good look at you.
That was a good starting hand. Triple one drop. Every one toughness thing you have, it would die. But, you know, if you attack with five creatures plus a Vladimir, so if you know, if you're attacking with six creatures, and one of them being a Vladimir, that does five damage straight up to the opponent like that.
I'll try anyone.
Yeah, the game is free. Yep. Yeah, go ahead, download it, do the tutorial. Absolutely, yeah. The game's free. It's very, very balanced. If you read, like, my piece about that. And it's pretty easy to earn new cards. You know, like, it has a really, really good reward system for playing. Yeah, it's the most friendly free-to-play of any card game for sure.
The people are my strength. Noxian strength.
Let's see what you can do.
Mark Vial is still really good. So they've had a really good hand, and we have, for the most part, you know, weathered the storm.
I've dressed for the occasion.
I'm down to the three cards in hand and these two little creatures. We'll see how well Vladimir can do. Yeah, it is more creature combat based. Definitely, I think it's more skill intensive, because of that, but they're some of the most popular decks. We're just playing a creature deck. We played against some creature decks here, but, some of the most popular decks are actually control decks. But yeah, it is more creature combat based now. Like, there is just one set. So like, it's not going to have like the, you know, 25 years of cards that Magic has, because there's just one set so far. But still, for that one set, it's incredibly well put together and very balanced.
My axe is ready.
Darius. No, I don't think this is going to be a paper game. I mean, just like similar to Hearthstone, like this game is not made for paper.
Let me show you what I can do.
Blood isn't a toy, dear. People are.
It is coming to mobile. Whenever, you know, it's in the open beta phase right now, but whenever it fully releases, which is going to be in the first half of 2020, it'll be available on mobile, which is pretty awesome. You'll be able to play on your phone. Daniel says, I've been playing for about 14, 15 days and have 45% of the collection. Yeah, that's pretty awesome. All right, so if I attack out, the Vladimir would kill the precious pet, but they would take 5, go down to 7. They would also take 2 from the Crimson Disciple, so go down to 5. So they would be at 5 life immediately if I just attack out. And which means that they have to have the 6/5 block the Darius, which means that they can't block these fearsome creatures, which would then kill them. So pretty sure this is lethal. Unless this is like a pump spell to make something else fearsome. Or life gain somehow. That is not good, blocking the 2/3 with the 1/1 that will deal more damage to you whenever it survives that also. They really need to have the 2/3 block that. They don't have a block to survive. Good job, Vladimir. And big overwhelm creature. And we're 2-1. Ugh. Need to draw like 2 more cards. We're so close to a champion capsule. Which hopefully we'll get that there. Yeah, I don't know, Bice Cream. Right now I'm not really planning on it. I'm kinda, you know, I've been playing Magic for ooh, we're playing against somebody with a number. You know, I've been playing Magic for like 10 years all the time and kind of wanted to switch it up, you know? What are they playing? Karma Lux? We don't really need Vile Feast. I like that how it's, even though it's a best of one game, I really like how before you make your mulligan decision, you know basically the archetype of what your opponent's playing. You at least know the champions that they have. And that makes it where you make a, you know, well-informed mulligan decision for your best of one game. So it's not like, you know, you keep a hand that's all anti-aggro and then you play control and you're like, well, I just threw away this game. And then, you know, you go to, so then you, you know, so then you had to have the sideboarding. And then, you know, like you go to sideboarding and then you keep a two lander and you don't hit a third land drop. And so then you're like, well, I just lost that match.
There's nothing to fear.
Really like how games aren't like that. You want to do a Yasuo stun deck? Yeah, I'm not... Okay. Yeah, I'm not sure... Yeah, I don't know how good a Yasuo stun deck is. I haven't tried that, because that's a champion that I haven't crafted and worked towards. This is difficult not playing more stuff before combat. But it's probably the... It's the safe thing just to go straight to attacks.
My path is clear.
I got one spider right now.
They grow up so fast.
Yeah, best of three can take forever for one match, that is true. Especially those post-war games like where you try to, you know, get a lot, like they get so grindy, you know, like where you bring in a bunch of card advantage, they bring in a bunch of card advantage. That's fun.
Let me show you what I can do.
So this is basically going to be impossible to beat. Running through an A3 that they also gave tough. I'm just hoping they don't have any more protection for it. Yay, they don't. And see, I wanted to do that first because, you know, like they gain 8 life, but you can't go above 20.
Silent as death.
Their spirits and their souls.
The dark beckons.
So they're gonna have their protege kill one of my spooky spiders. Yeah, I am really glad about the whole mana ramp thing. That's something that's really annoyed me with the current standard, how it's been, how Simic just gets such huge mana advantages, and it's really unfun to try to play any kind of mid-range deck like that you're not ramping, because you just can't keep up. and you just can't play other colors in mid-range at all. That's one thing, that's probably the thing that I like about this game the most is there isn't that inherent unfairness. Yep, damage is accumulative on creatures. Yeah, they don't regenerate at end of turn like in Magic. You can heal them, you know, like so they can be healed back up to like their, you know, and there is an ability called regeneration. So some creatures have regeneration and they do, but in general, damage is not like that.
You cannot escape.
So right now this attack would be for 8 on them. I have a pump spell that can make it 10. Huh. This is doing 2 damage to everything. Do you think the timer, if you wait too long to take your turn, is too quick for in here? It could be just a tad bit slower. Like there's times that I'll run out of time, but it's not too bad. It's pretty fair.
Oh, I can't wait.
So I guess if they have a second judgment, like that's the only thing that can save them right now is a second judgment. And I'm not really sure how best to play around a second judgment. I would love to draw a pump spell. It's not a pump spell. But yeah, they just have another judgment. I am in a ton of trouble. If not, I win. So it's like... like, they probably are playing 3 Judgment. Like, this deck probably has 3 Judgment. So do I go for the win? But if they have Judgment, I'm in a ton of trouble. Or do I try to play around it somehow? How would we play around it? So we'd do, like, this... I don't even know how I'd play around it.
My turn.
I don't love any alternative, so I'm just gonna hope they don't have another judgment. If they do, I lose. If they don't, I probably win. Or okay, sweet. Yay. Judgment can just be such a blowout. All right, 1300 XP. We're at 2650 out of 4000 for that. Each win with this mode just gives us 100, so we're looking at like, you know, 14 wins. Get into that champion capsule from here, but we may have another extra bonus. Yes, so this has an alternative, or sorry, this has an AI that you get to play against, And if you play against the AI, you get XP, so you actually can rank up. So you actually get XP from playing, like, it's like different forms of XP for playing, like, versus players, versus AIs, and also 1v1. You can get XP from that also. Like, you know, just playing against a friend. But, you know, like, you don't get to just play against the AI all day and just get unlimited XP. It like, runs out after a while. But, yeah, the capsules have cards from the different region. What am I playing against? Elise Hecarim. They have different cards from the region. Right now, I'm in the Freljord region. You get to choose what region you want to get your rewards from, but, you know, like, just basically leveling them up pretty similarly. But right now I'm in Freljord, so we're gonna get a champion from Freljord plus some other stuff. Okay, so it's 0 XP from losses after 10. Would that even make sense to drain my own thing? I guess it'd be the same as draining theirs. Then they don't gain a life. Cool. So I wasn't gonna be able to like flip Elise here, so I wanna play Elise at the end of their turn and just play Elise and immediately flip Elise. Oh no, they just passed back. Just kind of wasted that.
I pull the strings.
I didn't think they would pass back. Oh no, and it started the round also. Alright, I got too greedy. Too greedy.
Where's my axe? I'll do better this time.
Hey, Ravolki.
Let me change into something more.
Yeah, I'm doing with cards that I want. Like right now, I want Anivia. I have no Anivias, and so that's what I'm doing. Freljord, but Freljord's also it's the region that have the least amount of champions. Like I don't really have Freljords or Ash, and I do have Braum, and I can't think of the other Freljord one right now. Burst spell. I don't do anything, I go down to 5. I guess they Guess they're gonna have burn spells too. Come on. So I get for not blocking, I guess. Yeah, whatever. Alright, I think I had the tools to win that game. I think I just played that game pretty poorly. I think that game was on me. Puppy's in the other room. Harvey is laying down here on her pillow next to me. Puppy must be just in the living room laying on the couch. That's where she usually is when I'm streaming. So yeah, that game was my bad. It's a difficult game. Difficult game. Yeah, I allow the pets on the furniture. It's basically just Puppy now. Like, Harvey is kind of too big to get up on the furniture. She doesn't. Well, that she just has three legs, so she can't really climb up on the furniture. I like adding. Ooh, I like that Thresh in Ezreal. Thresh is pretty sweet. Your dog has its own couch.
Take from the rich, give to me. Don't blink, or you miss me. No sweat.
Just borrow it. So they're gonna let their Ezreal die to a vial offering. I don't have one, but
sounds dangerous.
A little surprised by that. By that block.
There's nothing to fear.
Shoot the 2-1. So I think my plan right now is like they shoot the 2-1, I sack it, draw 2, and then I had something die, I play the crawling sensation, so I have 3 spiders, at least flips. I can have like the 1-1s grab the Ezreal.
Charge.
Hmm.
darkness.
Nope, I guess I shot Elise.
Meet Gauntlet. You're between me and glory.
I must have just a hand of Ezreal's, I guess.
Show you what I can do.
Thresh is so good. Such an underrated champion.
Come play. Yes, you.
So the options are either sack it, draw two, or give it +3/+3. And then put the Thresh down to one.
Who's my favorite? It is you. Yes. The strings.
Which, of course, for where we're at, I wish I would have done the Mark of the Isles with a blocking.
A tribute to the
yeah, True Shot Barrage is good. I like that card. I haven't cast it very much. It's cast against me all the time, and usually a pretty big blowout when it's cast against me.
I'd never keep my guests waiting. Where can I find a full box?
This Thresh is just going to dominate.
We must all make sacrifices.
Really wish I would have done the Mark of the Isles line.
Let me change that was, something more.
That's where I really lost this game, was not doing the Mark of the Isles line before. And I could have put the Thresh down to one health, and then I, because, you know, then I drew multiple Vile Feasts after that. That was where I lost this game. Great. I don't really know how I'm being double Ezreal. I mean, I guess the answer is just I'm not.
Check me out.
GG Thresh. GG. I think Thresh is the most underrated champion in the game. All right, pretty good hands. I could see putting back this Arachnid Horde, because I think I'm going to want to play this spider turn 2. Make sure that works. That gives me turn 4 of playing the 2 spiders.
No. They picked the wrong row? From the trees.
There's no way they just don't play anything if I pass, right?
The Yordle here is with me.
Looking for this.
I don't know if this was Green Glade Duo was a 2-1, if they would have traded with the 3-2 or not. But now they don't really have the option to. They have a lot of mana, likely have protection. Yep, they had protection. But I was hoping they didn't. More attacks.
Not disappoint me.
Where are you going?
No, I don't think the spiders are too underpowered. No, I don't think so. Yeah, there's a lot of buffs you can use for the spiders. I think they're good.
Hang on, Buzzball.
Hey.
I'll try anyone.
Psst, act natural. I got you.
All right, we're gonna try to go wide. And of course I could sacrifice. Oh, that.
Hey, Krabby.
That's a good draw.
open. Watch for branches.
Don't have Kai got it.
That could be me being dead. I should do this before combat in case I draw a removal spell.
I know a way.
Okay, not dead. Not dead yet, at least.
Elise.
I wish I had one more spot and I could play the Skitter. Ooh. I get another spot. There we go. Oh no. That's bad. That was like the best card they could have. All right, 4-3-3. So 3-3-2-4. All right, we're at least going to kind of trade off battlefield position unless they have a trick, but we were going to be able to like blow them out. That was going to be really good for us.
I'll take care of this.
Yeah, just been playing Magic for you know, so many years and everything, Jinek. Just wanted to try something new. This new game, Legends of Runeterra, is the real deal. This game is awesome, and kind of felt like switching. Seems like they have a trick, because they're... No, they do have a trick. Alright, well... That's probably game then. We gotta be pretty lucky about what we draw here. Hey, Toasted. Nope.
Walk softly, strike quickly.
Man, our Vladimir Spiders is not doing very good today. Not doing very good today. The other time we played this, we went 6-1 with the deck. Ugh. Can just kind of show though like how close these games are and everything. Like it's, there's certainly variance back and forth with this game because all the decks are so close. Like it's not, there's not a lot of margin between winning and losing. So I'm expecting that to be a deck built around barriers, and why I think that's why I kind of want Vile Feast.
You won't get past me.
I feel like the spiders for us haven't been powerful enough. Like, you know, we've had too many of like these 1/1 spiders that haven't been powerful enough. We haven't had, you know, like our 4-mana overwhelm creature. We basically have not had that creature at all. We had it like one game, and we won that game. But besides that, we've basically not had that game, or sorry, not had that card.
can't wait. I need no weapon.
Really don't like this deck that my opponent's playing.
What's that noise?
I've lost to it a lot recently, but it's just so boring. Play that, standalone it, now next turn they just play Rally and then I lose. And it's just... don't like it at all.
I'll do better this time.
As fate wills. Tread lightly, strike hard. I need no weapon.
Yeah. What a fun game. Get a 3-mana 4/3 flyer and standalone it immediately because you save up. So turn 3, you get a 7/6 flyer, and then the next turn you just play Rally and you get 2 attacks, and so 7 times 3 is 20, you're dead. The standalone combo deck. Well, not performing good today. You can see the records right there. We're 2-6. Last time we played it, we were 6-1. Today we're 2-6. A lot of variance because of how good, you know, like these games are pretty close, and last time they're going our way, this time they're not going our way. Mark of the Oz is good. I like that card. Purify has really been overperforming recently, because those kind of decks are pretty popular, and just regular old barrier stuff is really popular. And so Purify is a card that has gotten pretty good these days. Oh, okay, yeah. I like both these Vlad decks, you know, so these are, you know, we're playing two different Vladimir decks today, the Spider version and the Rally version. You know, last time we did pretty well with both of them. Of course, as I was just saying, we're not doing well with the spiders today, but I still like it. All right, going for a big attack. There we go. Skitter, pretty nice. We had the Mark of the Isles to be able to do some extra damage as well. You're thinking about building a Teemo Rally deck for Puff Caps maximization. Okay. I like that, Teemo Rally. And then you can have barriers and stuff with, since you're playing Demacia. Yeah, links for the decks. Exclamation point decks. There's all the decks right there. There and there. Of course, Josh. That's what I'm currently doing right now. Oh, sorry, the previous song. I'll go right back to this. The previous song was by Placebo, Every You, Every Me.
Where's my axe?
So we had a 1, 2, 3, so I mulliganed the 2-drop, since we already had those, but the deck was like, no, you get more 2-drops. Here's another one. Here's the one you mulliganed. Here's another. More 2-drops.
I'll do better this time.
Slow start for the Kinku Elusive deck. They can make, like, big lifelinking flyers that are really hard to beat, though, so it's not like... Don't have like grand illusions that we're super far ahead right now. I wanted to wait on the. I didn't play the Skitterer last turn, so I wanted to wait on it for this turn to get the pump in.
First step's the hardest.
Something for the road.
Okay.
Looking for
this. Surprised they don't have the 2-3 block one of the like the 1-1 or 2-1.
My true beauty.
All right, so we're able to flip Elise. And... if they just kind of tap out, like now that they're at 4, I can play Vladimir and just go straight to attacks and attack out, and the Vladimir trigger will just kill them.
These are dangerous.
And we don't have to worry about lifelink.
I'd never keep my guests waiting.
I guess they have that though.
I'm absolutely lost.
All right, so this attack, we'll have the Vladimir trigger kill my 2-1-1. So these don't get to do any damage. All these will be unblockable. All right, and finished up with a win. All right, so 4-6. So, you know, still not... You know, not like the worst record. Yeah, Challenger is so good. We saw that we were just kind of a little too small. Like, a lot of our losses were, you know, like, we're going wide pretty well, but we were just too small. Like, we had too many of the small stuff. And we didn't have... I don't know how to... I need to turn off that noise. If I can, but anyway, you know, like crowd favorite's a big part of this deck. You know, when we're going wide, we only drew crowd favorite like one time ever in 10 matches. And as far as I know, I think we only played it one time and, you know, like we won the turn we played it. I remember last time whenever we were doing so well, crowd favorite was a big part of it. you know, playing 5-5, 6-6, 7-7 trampler. And yeah, we, so that I think that that was kind of a big deal, not really ever having crowd favorite. But besides that, I didn't really like this Hapless Aristocrat. I think I would be pretty fine getting rid of this card moving forward and going with something a little more power. I think that the, like these for one drops, the rear guard and the pet are good enough. I don't really didn't really like that Aristocrat. As far as what to play for something with a little more power for the last card, I mean, you could have like a Rasa, you know, you could have something like that, but I wonder if Shunpo would be good in this deck. Deal two, then rally with how we have our, how we get to go wide and everything. I could see that. I could see playing like just like playing like one might to, you know, give like one of your spiders, make it bigger. Maybe an Arachnoid Sentry, but I was thinking like some other, like one other like trick or something up at the top end. Vengeance, I think, is too expensive. I could see like a Rasa. I'm not sure. You know, I have to kind of go through here, see what we'd really want. I don't know, like, would we want to play just give your allies +1/+0 burst speed for how we go wide and everything? Would we want that actually? Like maybe for how wide we go. I don't know. But I didn't like that extra one drop. I want one other powerful card at the top end. I think if I had to pick something for now, I mean, I guess Arachnoid Host is probably better than that. Arachnoid Host is really isn't that bad. Brothers Bond, that's a good one. Brothers Bond is awesome. That is a good one. I do like Brothers Bond a lot. Yeah, I'm in for a Brothers Bond. I like that card quite a bit. I wouldn't mind another, or even just a Legion Saboteur. I think Legion Saboteur is probably a better one drop than Hapless Aristocrat, but. So there you go. So there's like a slot to play around with if you have a specific card, or you know, like whatever you have in your collection, if you have something that you really want to play. You know, Captain Farron is kind of interesting. Captain Farron, Rasa, those kind of things are interesting. You know, could play if you want another spider and Arachnoid Sentry. Could play a Battlecaster. That was the other one that I was kind of thinking of, was like Arena Battlecaster, because we're going wide, and you know, Battlecaster can is pretty sweet also. That may be better than Brothers Bond. Things to think about. Do like Battlecaster a lot. Would I rather have Battlecaster or Brothers Bond? I'll just keep the Brothers Bond in there for now. But, alright, there we go. There's Vladimir Spiders. Kieran Faye with the Twitch Prime sub. Thank you so much there, Kieran Faye. Our second sub of the day. Brand new Twitch Prime sub. That's awesome. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah, so going with the Brothers Bunk. That is true. We do have a lot of 2-mana creatures. That's a good point there. Going wide means on the battlefield, playing a lot of creatures. That's what going wide means. All right, so there we go. There's Vladimir Spiders. Those of y'all watching on YouTube, hit that like button over there. You know, feel free to leave those comments. Let me know how the deck's playing for you if you're trying it out at home. Anything that you found that you think I need to update or change or anything like that, you know, feel free to leave those comments over on YouTube. But that's it here for Vladimir Spider. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.